What's going on, guys? It's Wafers, and welcome back to the Newport County Road to Glory Career Mode. It's episode 38, and today we are starting off season 4, our first season in the Premier League. We have a lot to get through in this episode. We're going to be going through the transfer window and then heading into our first game ever in the Premier League. It's an exciting episode for sure, and a lot of stuff to get through, as I said. So I accepted our invite to the preseason tournament. I will be simming that whole thing, and then we will be getting through the transfer window, and our first game against Man City is going to be a hard one to start off the season. Looking at the league table, as you can see, Brentford and Brighton are both there. They got promoted alongside of us, and then you'll notice some other familiar faces, your usual suspects in the Premier League, along with teams like Fulham and Leeds, who have managed to stay up. There we are, our first season in the Premier League, alongside Sheffield United, who have also been able to stay up in this career mode so far. Just remember that we are 4 seasons in, so the teams might be a little different, and we'll have to see that as we play them. Looking at our objectives for this season, our youth development objective, it's within 2 seasons, sign 2 youth players and play them in 10 matches. Should be pretty easy, but I am going to wait to send out our scout until we are done with the transfer window, just so that in case we need that money, it's not locked up already in the scout. Brand exposure, 5 clean sheets. We'll see how that goes. I don't know. We should be able to get 5 at least. And then for domestic success, avoid relegation is the board's goal, and that is my goal as well. For the FA Cup, it's only reached the round of 32, which is good because in the past it's been, getting farther than that, like quarters or semis. But for now, it's just to avoid relegation, which is also my goal. Just stay in the Premier League. Financial should take care of itself. Increasing the club's worth, as our players get better, the club will also get better and will become worth more. Looking at our budget for this season, and we do have £27 million with £93,000 in the wage budget, a massive increase from our past budgets, and we will be spending that money. If you have been watching the series, you will know that we have not spent money in terms of signing a player from another team yet in this career mode. We have gotten all of our players from the youth squad or from free agents. We have yet to make a purchase on the transfer market, but with this big increase, we will be spending our money. Looking at the squad, Peter Conlon has kept his exciting prospect tag, which is good to see. I expect a lot of growth from him this season. Unfortunately, Alex Wynn has not gotten a potential tag this season, but that's all right. He should still grow by 4 or 5 ratings this season, I would expect. He's grown pretty steadily over his career with the team, so I wouldn't expect anything less from him this season. Just going through some more players as we look for any changes in potential tags, and as we get down to the center midfielders, you will see that Ibrahim Marsh does have an exciting prospect tag, which is really good. I expect him to probably grow around 6 ratings this season because of that tag. If we're able to play well, he should grow pretty well and get into the low 80s. Harry Coughlin is able to keep the potential to be special tag, which is really nice because in my experience, usually they go down pretty easily from that tag. He was able to keep it, so that's really great. Should see a lot of growth from him as well. Jude Holmes, down to showing great potential, we'll try to send him out on loan. And then Alex Bennett also has an exciting prospect tag. We know he's always going to grow. He's always going to be good, although his potential tag has fluctuated during his career. He will get into the low 80s, I expect, this season as well. Going down into the wingers, and we get to Adam Rollins, who does keep his potential to be special tag, which is really, really nice to see. We should expect a lot of growth from him this season. He was only up for half a season last time, and he grew, I would say, about 3 ratings. So we should expect a lot of growth from him this season. I wouldn't be surprised if he gets close to 80 overall. Hopkins, I did offer him a contract and saw his potential tag. He doesn't have one, but he should still grow probably into the low 80s. And then Jenkins, he does have showing great potential. Dom Telford does not have a potential tag, which means that Jenkins at some point in this season might overtake Telford. They will split time this season between that starting striker role. And then I decided to go give some of our youth players that have been with us for a while some new contracts. I wanted to make sure that they were happy. I saw some of them were displeased with their contracts while I was going through. And so I want to make sure that they're happy and they want to stay here. So we give Hopkins a new contract. We also give Bennett a new contract. All of these contracts are around the £27,000 per week to £30,000 per week mark, which I think is pretty fair. We also give Marsh one. All these, you know, those three players are all 77 overall. So I think that's pretty fair for being in the Prem. And then we also will go and give Conlon a contract around £9,000 per week. And then I also go give Wynn a contract for also around £9,000 per week. Our center back pairing is very strong. I think it'll be around for a long time. So it's good to get them signed up to extensions and get them on good contracts. Our first offer for this transfer window is Dom Telford. We will reject that. We're not looking to sell him yet. But then we do get an offer from Leeds for Marcelo Castellon, a player that is a backup player, plays sometimes, has done all right, but we do have other options. And I was negotiating with them, and we do agree to a £3 million transfer fee. So as long as that goes through, we will be getting some money for Marcelo Castellon, a player that we did sign out of free agency. So that's just £3 million pounds worth of profit right there. We do see that he has gone to Leeds, and we do get a transfer budget increase because of that. We get an offer for Henry Akujobi. I'm not looking to sell him. He's a very good backup center back to have. So we will keep him for now. And then Jude Holmes, we do get a transfer offer, a loan offer, sorry. But I will have to delegate this to get it to be only a loan and not a loan to buy. After that, we also get another loan to buy offer. This one for Michael Prosser. But we will also delegate this one and try to get it to be just a simple one-year loan. Looking to get both of our cams there, some experience outside of the club. They're not going to play a lot this season, so I want to get them some experience outside of the club in order to help them grow. And then maybe we can sell them down the line, or they could be good backup players once they grow a little bit. We do accept that loan offer for Jude Holmes. We'll have to see if it goes through. And then we get an offer for Peter Conlon. We will reject this. A decent offer from Fulham, £9.2 million. We also get an offer for Tristan Abrahams, and I will be accepting this. He didn't really play a lot last season, and I think it'd be nice to cash in on him right now and let him play somewhere else. We end up getting a response back from Galatasaray for our one-year loan for Prosser. They do agree with that, so we will have to see if he gets loaned out. We find out that Holmes has been loaned out and Abrahams has been sold. So two good pieces of business right there, a loan and then a player heading out. And after that, I was looking to splash some cash and make our first signing of the career mode, really. I'm going for Nico Williams, the Welsh right back. He's now at Juventus. He's only 22 years old and he's 76 overall. And I want to bring him back to Wales for our first season in the Prem. He'd be a big upgrade, and we are able to agree to a transfer fee with Juventus for £17 million. It's a big transfer for our first transfer. And we are splashing the cash right away, looking to make big improvements to the squad. We then go and we will negotiate a contract with him. And we are able to agree on terms for £32,500 per week with a £350,000 signing bonus. And Nico Williams is joining the squad. He's going to be our new starting right back, and we add another Welsh player to our team. And this transfer window, I was really focusing on trying to bring in Welsh talent. I was looking around and I found Rabbi Matondo in the free agent section, 76 overall, only 22 years old, can play across the front three positions in our team, and I'm able to negotiate a contract with him for £28,000 per week. And I don't think he'll start. I want to start Rollins at left wing, and then I still want to start probably Jenkins or Telford up top and Hopkins on the right, but he should be a super sub that comes on almost every single game. Then we look for a goalkeeper. I want an upgrade on Townsend, and we are able to find Jordan Shepherd, a new gen. He's a Welsh goalkeeper, 6'5", and we're looking to get some more Welsh talent into the squad. Well, this could be a really good opportunity to get a Welsh goalkeeper into the team. We're able to agree on a transfer fee for £2.85 million, and now we just have to negotiate a contract with him. As I said, he's 71 overall, only 21 years old, and he's 6'5", so he gets a really big presence in goal. We're able to negotiate a contract with him for £8,500 per week, and Jordan Shepherd is joining the squad. He will be our brand new number one goalkeeper, so really excited to get these three signings in. All Welsh players coming to Newport County to help us in our first season in the Prem. It's really exciting stuff, and I hope that they can contribute this season. We find out there that Prosser has been loaned out to Galatasaray, so wish him well on his loan spell. And then we get an offer for Josh Sheehan. He's been here since the beginning, but I think it's time for him to move on in his career. We will accept this offer and see if he transfers out. We then go to our youth academy, and we see we only have 5 players in this, but our crown jewel of the youth academy is none other than Connor Rees, the 16-year-old Welsh center attacking midfielder. He's 66 overall, 90 to 94 potential. He's guaranteed to have potential to be special. And I was thinking about it for a while, what I wanted to do with him, and I decided that it'd probably be best right now to call him up to the first team. He's going to be our backup cam option to Bennett. We're going to play him in all the cups and get him some experience with that super high potential. Before our first game, I wanted to change some of the numbers, so we give Jordan Shepherd the number one jersey. He is our number one goalkeeper. We will also go down to Nico Williams, and we will change his number. I believe here we're going to give him the number 2, since he is our brand new right back. And then I do decide to also go, I believe I change one more number here. If we go down to Matondo, I'm going to give him number 20 instead of 24. I just thought it'd be nicer to give him the number 20. And after that, we are ready for our first ever Premier League game. We are facing Man City. As you can see, we did the press conference, we're ready for the game, and we're into our game against Manchester City, a really tough opponent for the first time. And there were very little chances in this game. In the 86th minute, they would come forward, and they get so close here. Jordan Shepherd coming up with a huge save, and then we have a chance to try to win the game at the very end. We're into stoppage time, and we get forward. Harry Coughlin out of midfield shoots, Ederson saves, and they clear it. That is how it would end. We pick up a draw in our first ever Premier League match against Manchester City, and I am happy with that one. Just to be able to get a draw in our first match against a very, very good team that's sure to be contending for a title. It was a super tough match, and to get a point out of that is really promising for the rest of the season. But that's going to be it for this episode of the Newport County Road to Glory Career Mode. If you guys did enjoy it, make sure to drop a like on the video, comment what you think down below, and subscribe if you're new. And I'll see you guys soon for a new episode.